We're gonna change things up and try some new things over these next couple of videos and really peel back the curtain and let you know what life is like as a water cycle restoration practitioner. So let us know down in the comments what you think. If you hate it and think we should just stick to project videos, let us know. If you find this helpful and want to hear about other things, let us know. Let us know what you want to hear about. One of the really common questions that we get is, can you actually make money doing this? What is the job market like? A lot of people, they've done a PDC or they've done a soil class and they're still not able to make a career out of it. And so they're wondering, is our course just the same thing? Right now, it's an amazing time to be working in water. There is so much need all around the world. Wherever you are, in whatever kind of climate, I can almost promise you there's a need for people to have a better relationship with and management of the waters that they receive. So my clientele ranges from totally normal, typical families and farmers. Even farmers from all around the world really need these techniques and bring us in, even though the considerable expense, all the way up to governments, state departments, villages and communities, and some of the wealthiest families in the world. And so I can promise you there is no shortage of need and desire for this kind of work. What's really lacking is the people who know how to actualize this kind of work. There's a great movement going on in water, especially right now, and there's lots of people really bringing awareness to this, which is super important, really critical work. And there's this huge shortage of people that are actually doing the projects, realizing these theories and designs and ways of coming into better relationship with nature. So I can tell you it's a career or vocation that makes you feel really good, really fulfilled, and it also can be quite lucrative. You know, I've made all the money to start this dream project of mine, Water Stories, to train hundreds and thousands of people to do this type of work around the world. I made all of this money through performing decentralized water retention implementation for others around the world. If I hadn't invested this in Water Stories, I could have bought a home or all sorts of other things. And so if you do the work, if you put in the time, and if you really work hard, I can promise you it's gonna pay off. And the current job ecosystem is actually insane. There's so many projects, so much desire from all over the place. We have to keep raising our rates just because there's so many good projects coming in. You can't say no to them. And so we have to figure out some way to filter projects. And so this is a really good problem to have, but it's also, if we really want to make this type of transformation in the world, we need all of us contributing to this. And so that's why we created this course, this program, so that you can build your own company, so that you can get to work doing this in your region. Or if you want to do it on your own farm and homestead and make an example so that your community can learn from it, this really empowers you to do that. So a big question that a lot of people have is this actually going to enable me to make a career out of this? And I'll say, ultimately, that's up to you. But what we do is we give you all of the information you need to do that, not just the technical knowledge to set yourself apart. And so a lot of other trainings, they give you the technical piece, which is really important. It's critical. It's the essential core. But it's probably only 20% of delivering the work. There are all of these other pieces from, you know, how to make working relationships, how to have subcontractors, how to get projects, bid, estimate, invoice, contracts and agreements, all of these different pieces that are the 80% of creating a business, creating a livelihood doing this, which most programs just kind of glance over or don't cover at all. And so for this, what I did is I really started from scratch. I looked at, you know, I myself went from a recent graduate out of university that was a nobody in the field of water or ecosystem restoration to now all of a sudden I'm one of the leading people in decentralized water retention. And so I really looked at what was that 10-year journey like? What were the key essential pieces that I needed to get from where I was to where I am today? And what I did is I distilled those down into a 6-month training. So it doesn't just cover the techniques, doesn't just cover how to read landscapes and understand and create intuitively with the land, which is again the core piece, but it also covers how to develop yourself to have good working relationships with clients, how to set expectations appropriately so that you have good outcomes for the project that you do get, and most importantly, how to get yourself out there and create interest in people that want to hire you. And so these are all things that we go through in the actual content of the course, from how to make an estimate, how to generalize prices, how to get started, how to get that first client and then move it to your first successful work. A whole quarter of the course is dedicated just to the professional development that you need to actualize this work in your community. And it's also about the personal development that you need to be able to work with others. We all have our own strengths and weaknesses, and to move out and do this work in a meaningful way in the world, we need to first get really strong and centered in our core of why we're doing this, who we're doing it for, and who we are as individuals. So these are the pieces that are, a lot of times are just totally overlooked. And then through the process of the course, if you do all the actions, you know, it's an online course, but really it's an at-home course, an in-your-community course. Because if you do all the actions, it's going to lead you to doing this work in your community. For example, in one of the later parts of the course, we ask you to give a presentation in your community. And for some pathways, this is required. Now, you know, this is a big step for a lot of people. A lot of us need to be pushed into putting ourselves in that kind of public space. But then when people do it, that's what leads to projects happening in your community. And so without being pushed over the hump, people oftentimes won't take that step. They won't take that risk for fear of failure or a shame in the public space. But if you do the work, if you do that step, I can promise you it's going to lead to the next step. So we see, you know, I could cite so many different examples of students going through the course. They're just learning this. They feel very much a beginner in the space, but then they give a presentation or they give a workshop in their community. And all of a sudden that immediately leads to their first project. And then that successful first project leads to other projects. And similarly, students who want to do this as education and outreach in their community, they'll have, you know, maybe just one or two people for that first workshop before anyone knows about it. But if they put in the time and energy and create a positive learning experience for those one or two people, they tell their friends, and then at the next event, this person had 8 people. And then at the next event, they had 18 people. And you can see how it really starts to snowball and grow into this self-seeding movement where all of a sudden you have plenty of work. And so other students find that just being listed on our practitioner page already has people contacting them. But then we also have other students that get so wrapped up in doing the work before they're finished with the course that they don't end up even getting certification because they immediately move into doing the work in their community. So for a lot of people, this course has been the bridge. It's been the gap that they needed to go from interested and learning to actually doing as a profession or as a career. So one thing that I saw a lot of with other courses and why I was so hesitant to make a course myself is the lack of support for students moving into this work. Take your PDC, for example, your permaculture design course. You have a 72-hour download of information that is kind of an introduction to everything, and then you're told to do this professionally and given no support. And similarly with the normal permaculture design process, you have someone come in and develop a map. It's a really pretty map, and then they hand it off and say, okay, now do this, but you have no follow-up support. And that support is really critical to actually achieving outcomes. And so, for example, with our course, we have a whole alumni group, an alumni membership, where people can continue to learn and share with one another We have live professional development sessions with myself, so that as you're digging into your project, as you find something that you have a question about, you can ask it, you can get your question answered, and you can hear everyone's questions as they're working on this from all around the world and really learn quickly. So we can pull you through this 6-month experience, but then also support you afterwards, year after year, month after month. And so whether it's being highlighted to our audience, added to our practitioners page, or really just given that support and mentorship that's needed for success during those professional development sessions, we really focus on giving you the support to achieve the outcomes, not just to get started. And so for so many students around the world, this has been the event that enables them to move into this work full time, or enables them to implement this work on their land. It's really a journey much more so than a destination. And so we really try and set up where you're supported all the way through that journey. And so having gone through this experience of the course, you're forced to really understand your watershed, really understand the challenges, have a clear plan and proposal for the restoration of your local water cycle. You're forced to give a presentation in your community, to give a workshop, to have a first client, whether it's just for volunteer or pro bono with a friend or family, to get that process started so that you can do it once and then do it well. We have this real fear of failure, and we need to just start acting and doing things and learning from those failures. And so this is really our way to help support people actually moving into doing this as a profession. It's wonderful to understand it, to advocate it. These are all very, very important things, but most importantly, we need people doing these things on the landscape, getting their hands in the soil, their boots and feet on the ground, creating these transformations for a better common future. So I can tell you the job market is quite lucrative. And if you put in the work, you will get the outcomes and you will end up having this as a profession or a vocation or a really strong practice within your own landscape, your own ecosystem, your own connection and network of living beings in your own community. And so people always ask, after this course, will I be able to make this my profession? My answer is, that's up to you. If you put in the work, absolutely, 100%. We give you all of the support, all of the information, all of the guidance to get started. We give you mentorship through the process. And also it's important not to rush yourself. You know, it might take you a year or more to complete the professional track. It often does, but you have to get started and moving with your actions in that direction to get to that ultimate goal. So it's really a wonderful existence. I get to put my energy towards things I really believe in every day. I'm well compensated for that, and that empowers the type of life that I want to live. I get to travel around the world and learn from various cultures and people, helping them each step along the way. And I get to have these really positive, deep, meaningful connections with the people that I'm working with and for. And so if this is something you're interested in, I think you can't do yourself a bigger favor than to do this course, to really dive in for 6 months, grow your own experience, grow your knowledge, and grow your ability to create this as a practice. So let us know in the comments below. This is really different from our normal videos. Do you like it? Do you hate it? Do you want to see more of it? And if you do, what do you want to hear about? What are your questions that you want answered? What pieces of being a water cycle restoration practitioner really intrigue you or would help you on your journey? And if you like this kind of thing, come join us at waterstories.com, where we have films, videos, resources, and a whole training program to help you become a water cycle restoration practitioner.